الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه ثم أما بعد جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله إنا قوم من البادية فعلمنا شيئا ينفعنا الله سبحانه وتعالى به ما كان الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يسأل رحمة الله. We are a group from the Bedouin. So teach us something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala benefits us with. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا ولو أن تفرغ من إنائك في دلو المستسقي. Do not ever belittle anything good you do, even if it is to pour some water from your container to the container of the person who is asking for it. Little water. Then he said, وَلَوْ أَن تَلْقَى أَخَاكَ وَوَجْهُكَ مُنْبَسِطٌ إِلَيْهِ. Or even when you meet your brother with a smile on your face for him. وَإِيَّاكَ أَن تُسْبِلَ الْإِزَارِ فَإِنَّهُ مِنَ الْمَخْيَلَ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى يَكْرَهُ الْخُيَلَى. And do not wear your thobe below your ankle because it is arrogance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like arrogant people. وَإِنْ سَابَّكَ أَحَدْ بِمَا يَعْلَمْ فَلَا تَسُبُّهُ بِمَا تَعْلَمْ فَإِنَّ أَجْرَهُ لَكْ وَوَبَالَهُ عَلَيْهِ. And if someone curses you with something he knows, or someone يعني blames you for something he knows about you, do not do the same with something you know about him. The sin will be on him and the reward will be for you. One of those points here, the reward for never belittle a good reward. Imagine when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the size of the ant or the size of the atom. He rewards for that. So how can you belittle anything? Is there anything smaller than that that can tip the scale the day of judgment when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts the scales? وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا. If that size can make a difference for a person to go to Jannah or to go to hellfire, how can you belittle anything? There is nothing that you can do smaller than that or as small as that. Everything is way much bigger. Just like what Aisha radiallahu anha, when she gave a poor person half a date. Half a date. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, or who saw her, said, yani, what is this? What did you give her? She translated it in the ayah, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرَ يَرَى. قَالَتْ هَلْ تَعْلَمُ كَمْ مِنَ الذَّرَّاتِ فِي هَذِهِ التَّمْرَى. Do you know how many atoms in this piece of date? This is how you understand the Quran. That's how we reflect on the ayat of the Quran. It's not just read and know the meaning without thinking. Thinking is the issue. Thinking is the problem that we always have. So when you talk about little deeds, think of that. And a common epidemic is bad below the ankle. That is something, yani, even probably now when I talk about it, some people are going to look down at the issue. Yet Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is khuyala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates the one who wears his thobe below the ankle, right here. pantalón, bintal, thobe, whatever you wear, it should not exceed your ankle. No excuse. Unless you are exactly like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He makes sure that it's over, but because he's so scrawny or skinny, it slips. And he was so worried about the punishment, went to the Prophet ﷺ, and Prophet Muhammad ﷺ excused him. He said, you're not one of those. What does that mean? It's not because his intention is good. It's because you're doing your best to not do it and you cannot help it. This is like darura, or not darura, yani in the same level that this is something you cannot do anything about it. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told him, you're not. So here nowadays, you see the person wearing it, and if you tell him, he will laugh at you, or he would tell you, you look funny, or he would tell you anything but to understand this hadith. And he will use Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu as an excuse that he doesn't really understand the meaning of that. Not to mention that Prophet Muhammad ﷺ in a different hadith, he said, إِسْبَالُ الْإِزَارِ مِنَ الْمَخْيَلَةِ. Regardless of what you think, بغض النظر عن التفكير, سواء كنت في نية الخيلاء ولا في غير نية الخيلاء, إسبال مخيلة. والله سبحانه وتعالى لا يحب الخيلاء. بل الله سبحانه وتعالى, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, إن الله سبحانه وتعالى لا ينظر إلى من أسبل إزاره يوم القيامة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look at a person who wears his thobe below his ankle. And there is another part, فَمَا دُونَ الْكَعْبَيْنِ فَالنَّارُ أَوْلَى بِهِ أو فِي النَّارِ كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Anything below the ankles, in hell. Not the clothes, the foot will be in hell. And we know the punishment, the least punishment of the hell is who? Abu Talib. What is his punishment? Something he wears over his foot that makes his brain boil. So this foot that has the izar worn below will be in the hellfire. What does it say if you wear it with arrogance? No. Just anything exceeds that. So you have a punishment for arrogance, and you have a punishment for simply wearing it. Simply wearing it below, it will be in hell. If you have arrogance too, then add the punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not look at you the day of judgment, and a grievous punishment waiting. Imagine, you look at people and you just think, just because it's common, that means it's okay. Just because everybody wears it this way, it's okay. Just because that this is how the pants come, or this is how the clothes come, that means it's okay. You cannot fake it, you cannot shorten it, you cannot cut it, you cannot measure it. Why do we, wallahi, even if one, if someone says it's not, and with all these ahadith and all these scholars, you decide to go with the one who says it's okay and risk the other possibilities? It's hard. Wallahi, sometimes, I want people to think, wallahi, I'd rather look funny than go to him. And wallahi, the only one who would look at you funny is a person who has no relationship to the religion. But the Prophet ﷺ saw one of the companions wearing his pants low. He called him by name. He said, Irfa Izar. And then he ﷺ directed him to the half of the shin, to here. He said, Fa'in abayt, if you don't want it, if you feel shy, if you whatever reason, then فَإِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ فَمَا دُونَ الْكَعْبَيْنِ فِي النَّارِ. Maximum to your
ankle.
To your ankles. Anything below that is in the hellfire. My advice to all of you, wallahi. In fact, there is a weak hadith that if you pray with your isbat, your salah is not accepted. It's a weak hadith, but with all of these reports tells you how dangerous wearing your clothes below the ankle. Simple. Go spend $5, $10 and cut it short. If Jannah is not worth that, or protecting yourself from the hellfire is not worth that, I don't know. And in fact, look at the dua. The Bedouin asked, teach me something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala benefits me with. And look what he talked about. Why do you think he talked about it? More than likely, he noticed some of them wearing it that way. Because it seems like a little bit off the topic. It's talking about yani doing good and being good and all of that. And this one comes off the topic. Yani don't have isbat. Why? Because he probably sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw that. And the Bedouins are not easy to deal with. For the companion, he told him, raise your pants or your clothes. For the Bedouin, you know, they're harsh. You gotta take it easy with them. You gotta teach them lightly. So indirectly, he told him. Now people can reflect and said, oh, okay, well, I can do that. I guess I'm wearing that. Then he will take the advice indirectly. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always make us fulfill the sunnah, follow the sunnah, go to Jannah. Jannah and sunnah are equal. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum.